good evening, fellow Groove Riders. Will from Will's Electrical Services, also known as the Michael Essien of the electrical world, just doing bits. In tonight's episode, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a quick tour of some of my NWS hand tools, the VDE version. I had a request last week. I'd done a video last week. CK hand tools, very similar to this one, and I had a comment from A1 Electrical Services, and he is also on YouTube. He does the blogging type of videos. I highly recommend. I'll put a link above, and he requested if I had any NWS ones, he'd be interested in seeing a video. So I thought, yeah, why not? What it is I bought this set here for about 60 quid. And what you usually tend to find is that if you buy them in a set, you can usually get a pretty good deal. What I was after is I'm a massive Milwaukee fan. I was looking into some of their VDE tools, and I started to recognize like the handles and all that. And it turned out that they're rebranded like NWS ones. Like, even though I am a big Milwaukee fan, I weren't prepared to spend 90 quid for a set of the same set of three with just slightly different handles. I think that their handles are black, red, and yellow. And I wasn't so keen, you know. So I went for them ones, and I was quite happy with those. And I've also done a review of these ones, is I will go through them all individually at the end, but I got this set and I quite like those. And then Pete Bergs, he sent me down a set of these like to have a try, and these are really nice. I actually have used these quite a lot, and they're nice. They're very similar to a cropper, but they do have the serrated bits, so it seems to make it easier on the cables to cut them and all that. One concerning thing I have got, and I must say it might just be this one tool, but even though they've all got like this aluminium alloy finish, which does make the tools really light, which is quite a nice feature, especially I suppose if you're going to wear them in your belt or something like that, you know, it is a nice feature. But like, as I say, it has missing. I will do a close-up pictures of it, and I'll put it on the screen and all that so you can see. And then I bought this type here, which I'll explain in the end. But what I'll do is I will have a quick run through each tool. But before we do, if you could do us a massive favor, if you could show us your support, if you could like, subscribe and turn the notification bell on, it helps the channel grow. Right, so what it is I don't really use pliers very often, because I always carry around grips or like the pipe wrenches and all that. But like these pliers, these are actually quite unique, because they were quite unique to this actual brand, is that if you look on this bit here, they do have like a hexagon bit, and that is actually for like tops of bolts and nuts and stuff like that, which I should imagine be quite handy. And like, they've also got on the top there, they're very similar. I think I'm not sure if it was the CK ones or that, but they've got a hole there, and I should imagine that must be for doing the gripper wire, or it could also be for like pulling the draw wire. But yeah, it's quite nice. It's probably about a one mil, probably 2 mil hole going through there. It's quite nice. And also what they have got there is they have also got it like jagged along there, so I reckon that is probably for deburring like the end of like metal conduit and stuff like that, or pipes and all that. It is really nice, but the only problem is that I don't know if this chipping of that this chipping of the alloy is just a one-off, because you wouldn't really want to be doing that, because the added advantage of these where they're alloy like this is very similar to the CK ones, is that, you know, I reckon if you were to leave these outside, you'd probably be okay with them, because like a bit like the CK one where they're alloy, they obviously won't corrode or anything like that, because, you know, I've never seen any of these corrode. Like as I mentioned in the CK video, like that set of side cutters that I gave to Ollie that I found on top of that ducting, that had been outside for probably about 3 years, and they didn't even have a spot of rust on them. It's absolutely incredible. And like, they're really nice. Like the handles, you know, all the handles are the same. They're actually really nice as well. They're actually really nice and soft, these. And plus and all, which these do come as standard, which every single pair has got, is that they've actually got the they've actually got the holder bits there for the lanyards, you know, so obviously if you're working in a boom scissor lift and all that, you can obviously put the chain around your neck and all that so they don't feel. That is actually quite a unique thing really, because you don't really see many VDE tools with that actual feature on there, which is quite nice. I would love to know if anyone knows what that R means, because obviously that is the VDE symbol there, but I don't know what that R means. I don't know if it's an institute or something. I've got absolutely no idea, you know. And obviously we go back to, so where have we got to? We've done the we've done the pliers, now we've got the long nose. I like these. I keep these. I love not I, for some reason I always love long nose pliers. They're always my favorite. I always keep a set in my hand, so I've got a set in my hand tools, my test kit, you know. And even got the non-insulated video, another video I've done, the Nipex ones, the fully insulated ones. But yeah, these have also got the very similar bit parts to that. Obviously the lanyard parts, they're beautiful. They are. I really do like them. I might actually probably do a video on long nose. I know what you think. It's like, poor Jesus world, but hey ho, it is what it is. We go on. I've done a review of these, and these are really nice. I quite like these. I thought I'd use them a lot more than I did, but to be fair, this year we've been doing a lot of testing because of the PRS system and all that, so I've not really been using my hand tools that too much, because a lot of the first fix and second fix on the building side, we've got guys doing that for us now, so we're just concentrating on the testing side. They're really nice. I like the gun side, but like as I say, I've already reviewed them, so if you're interested in them, I highly recommend that video. And these are really funny set. These are, I bought these because a geezer I used to work with, who works for me on a Monday, he uses these. And like the good side of, one of the good things about these, which is a very different from all the other cutters, is that you can actually get into a very tight space with this, because especially like if you do pyro or mineral and some of the cables drop and all that, and you're in a beezer box or anything like that, you can get in really tight. These are really nice. And the guy, John, I was working with yesterday, he had the most unique set. And as I was saying about like these being rebranded, I've seen Furlough with them, and like the screwdriver brand and all that, they've been rebranded with these. Like them screwdrivers, I want to have a try with. I reckon they look really nice. And every time I do a review, everyone always mentions them, so I've got to give them a try. And what else? I'm going to pronounce it wrong now. So, Ingeborg Strice, is it? You know, like the clothing brand. John had a set of these, and what they were very unique. And I put them onto the screen, and what he was telling me, the top bit, the bottom bit are like that, and then the top bit is like that, but there's also a hexagon bit at the top. And I thought it was for a bigger bolt and all that, and I was talking to John about it, and he was explaining to me, he goes, what it is for like bigger armors and all that, so if you get anything probably 95 or maybe 70 mil hot upwards, it would strip it. And like, they look really nice. I'm actually going to look for a set of those, because they did look really nice, and I was quite impressed with them. And overall, like as I say, I'll probably, you know, if I was to pay the same price as what you'd probably pay for CK, then I'd probably be happy. I'm not saying that they're good or bad or anything like that, you know, like, because it's all each their own, but they don't seem to be that next level like Klein Tools or Knipex, Nipex or anything like that. But yeah, they're nice. The advantage is that they're light, because obviously they've got that like strange alloy, the same as, very similar to CK. The handles are nice, and obviously if you're working at heights, you've obviously got the lanyard hooks there as well, which is pretty handy. But yeah, it is what it is. They say they're made in Germany. But yeah, it's just another quick video. I hope you got something out of it. And don't forget, if you're going to be anything, then be electric. Up the old blues. Thanks for watching. See you next week.